bunch of people in Paris? Exciting!
No touche pas. Don't touch me.
You have to say, je m'appelle Mallory.
Hi, I'm Mallory. I'm 19 years old.
You all packed up?
Yeah. You ready to go? Or what time is it? I go to Iowa State University.
It's not a sideboard!
I was on scholarship playing for their team. I did give up my soccer scholarship to go to Paris.
Ready?
My life normally is very structured. I haven't had the chance to be very spontaneous.
Chris!
What?
You have everything packed?
Yeah.
My name's Chris, and I am 22 years old.
I just don't want you to fly. You don't want to go to Paris. The French people don't even like Americans.
My mother is terrified of me going to France.
I just want to get over that flight.
She is scared that the plane will explode, crash, hijacked.
Up and down, straight through.
Just really be careful out there, you know, in France I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I am going to miss you, though. Just make sure you keep in touch.
It's the most important people in my life, my mom and dad.
If you have the love and support of your family, you can do anything.
I think deep down my parents are very disappointed that I'm giving up the soccer scholarship, but I want this to be about my life. I want this to be about growing. I want this to be about learning, about experiencing.
Take care of yourself, you know? Seriously. You know, call us, you know? Just be careful out there.
I will.
I think my mom does want to keep me as her little girl.
I definitely will come see her in Paris and pray that everything goes according to God's plan for her.
I'm very nervous, but I'm so incredibly excited to go to Paris.
Bonjour.
This is the true story.
C'est une histoire vraie.
Seven
strangers.
Sept étrangers. Picks to live in France.
In a chateau.
Work together and have their lives changed.
They love you.
Found out what happened.
When people stop being polite.
Bring it on, dog.
Stop being real.
The real world. Paris.
Les sauvages.
Les encablots un peu homo érotiques. Danser se déchaîne comme un fou.
Ces jolies filles gandues qu'on appelle passe-partout.
Yeah! Hello! Americano! Alright! So far so good!
Yo, what's up?
Hey, it's 23 Statesboro. Where I'm from, I know every single person, and I feel like I'm a big fish in a little pond.
My name is Leah, I'm 22 years old, and I'm from Glen Cove, New York.
Hi!
Hello.
What's up?
How are you doing? Yeah.
Hi!
I'm so glad to see America.
I know! What's your name?
Ace.
Ace, I'm Leah.
Leah, nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too.
I talk to him, and I hear this southern accent. And I'm just like, oh, how cute are you?
Where are you from?
New York.
Are you kidding? Really?
Where are you from?
From Georgia.
Nice! Yeah. Walk down the stairs and make a right on avenues in New York. Just graduated from college, and I'm ready to start a whole new chapter in my life.
I'm so glad to see you.
I know! I'm so excited!
I think those are the tickets in there.
You used to be in the subway, right? You were in the subway?
Yeah.
I've never been.
Really?
Okay.
I'm
from a small town.
When I look at Ace, I see a lot of innocence.
What is her name? Is it middle of the day? Bonsoir? Bonsoir now? Bonjour's morning, right?
Bonsoir. Morning and afternoon.
I was in a French play, and voilà, c'est méchant loup, which is like actually being about wolf.
Ace is cute. He's great and he's funny, and I would like to be able to establish a friendship with Ace. I'm
a little bit nervous as I wait at the airport to get picked up. I have no idea what's going to happen, and that's really, really exciting. Relationship up until this point. I think I might be ready for one.
Hey! I saw you pass, so I wasn't sure if it was you.
When I first meet Chris, he just seemed like, he seemed a little bit full of himself.
Nice to meet you.
We're gonna be family now.
Fred. Yes, we are.
I'm like a Tootsie Roll lollipop. You gotta work around the hot edge first and get to the soft side.
Taking you directions as to where the house is?
Do you know how to get to the Paris trains? Man, what's going on? Do you know how to get to the Paris trains? Do you know how to get to the Paris trains? Excuse me, monsieur? Of course not. I'm trying to talk to strangers. No one wants to talk to me. I'm getting pissed off because I can't find this train station.
Don't mess with me, horse, because I lay down the laws. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man.
Anybody know how to get to the Paris trains? Does anybody know where the trains are?
Who's the man?
I have no clue where we're going. I just hope we make it to the house.
You have a girlfriend at home?
I was kind of seeing the girl for a while, but not really. Kind of.
The attraction I have to Ace, it is because he has things about him that remind me of someone that I used to be in love with.
Oh my God, I think we're going the wrong way. Maybe we should get off because I think we're going the wrong way.
Mercury is rising up, stirring up your Shangri-La, confusing everything.
God, I hope we're not supposed to be on the other side.
I'm gonna put you in charge. I put Lee in charge, so if we do get lost, it was all her fault.
I can't wait to find out what our job is.
That's what I'm excited. That's what I'm kind of nervous. I'm more nervous about that than anything, because I haven't had a job in my 5 years, 6 years.
You've never had a real-life job?
Well, I mean, I own a couple businesses in Statesboro.
What kind?
I own 3 bars. I have the most wonderful grandmother in the world. She gave me all the money to start my first business.
Who's taking care of him while you're here?
It's my other partner's wife.
So. Oh, okay.
He looks very young. He owns 3 bars. I'm thinking, good for you.
Hey, now it's lit up on that side.
What?
It's lit up on that side, man.
No!
So we go.
How does it change?
Mercury is rising up, stirring up your Shangri-La, confusing everything.
Oh my God.
There it is. Paris by train. What's the first thing you're gonna do?
I just want to go around the city. And the Louvre is the famous art museum. I love art so much.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. That'll be our first date.
Oh, okay.
I'm thrilled to be here. It's such an unbelievable place. I'm so happy.
I do. I am.
You
want to
dance?
What?
You want to dance? I look at Mallory and think that she's very nice, and Mallory's mature for her age. I think she has a wild side in her. She just needs a little help, you know, getting that side of her out. I'm excited.
Yeah, me too.
I'm so overwhelmed as I'm walking to our house and I'm in this neighborhood. It is so beautiful.
Wow. There it is.
Wow.
Wow. Bonjour. The house is fantastic. It's just unbelievable.
No. Oh my. Look at this!
Just like a kid in a candy store.
So cool!
There's another floor.
Oh my gosh! Yes! Yes, yes, yes!
There's another floor.
Oh my gosh!
don't want to pick that.
We can't pick that right now.
I really don't think that it's fair to just get in the house and state your claim.
Wow, this room is gorgeous. Woo! Oh, I love Paris.
I'm in France. I've only been in France for about 2 minutes, and I have no idea where I'm going.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Je ne sais quoi.
Ne comprends pas le français.
Ah, je ne comprends pas.
Do you speak English?
Un peu.
It's a complete language barrier. I can't communicate with anybody.
What's your name?
That's English.
I'm Adam. I'm
Christina, nice to meet you.
You must be my roommate.
My name is Adam. I'm 23, and I'm from Beverly Hills.
Hi, my name is Christina. I'm 24 years old, and I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm a cocktail waitress. I'm not a stripper, because people ask me that, and they automatically assume, girl from Vegas, are you a dancer, are you a stripper? I'm like, no.
I was just messing with you.
It's very exciting for me to meet girls.
I don't speak French.
Never got straight A's, went to Stanford, didn't have any trouble there. Always kind of succeeded in everything. There's nothing else that really poses a challenge to me in my life, except women.
Do you know where we live?
No.
You and I are gonna have to find this.
You're kidding.
I'm so bad with directions.
I'm great with directions, but I'm in France.
Oh my God, this is so pretty.
Hey, that's our house. That's
that?
Yeah, and that panel.
Wait, that's our house right
there. That's our house right there. Isn't that cool?
Let's go.
Hello.
Hello. We have visitors. There's someone in the house. Hi.
Hello.
Come on in. Check this out. My name is Mallory.
I'm Leah.
Nice to meet you, Leah.
Leah is awesome.
Nice, man. How you doing, bro?
Nice one, Ace.
Ace, he's my man. I love the guy already, I can tell.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Yeah.
Love it. Mallory is really, really beautiful. The way she smiles, her lips and her eyes, I mean, she's just stunning.
Okay, do we turn left?
All the way down here and then left.
Let's go all the way down?
All the way down.
Baby, you've ridden me all over town.
Okay, listen.
Yeah, my battery's dead. My belt is loose, I will break down.
Okay, this is Patounoir.
Adam, he's asking everybody around where everything is, and I'm just like, we have to ask young people because young people know how to speak English.
Et ensuite, vous retournez à droite au niveau du tunnel.
Okay.
Et vous continuez tout droit et vous allez croiser la route de Croissy.
Merci beaucoup.
Bonne journée.
Adam looks at him like he completely understood what he said, so I'm all like, yeah.
I don't have the foggiest idea what he said.
Baby, you've ridden me all over town.
Go get him.
Excuse me.
The crossing. Yeah.
It's on the other side?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Percy.
Yeah. I think he said something about accompanying us there.
Accompanying us there.
He said something about company. I think it is. I think these kids.
Do you think they know where they're going?
If they don't, I'm going to take his bike.
I'm Simon. I'm 18 from Wicklow in Ireland.
Main anxiety is meeting the other six housemates.
Nice to meet you. I'm
Simon.
Mallory.
How you doing?
Hi, Simon. Good. I'm Leah.
So, the Americans themselves are very enthusiastic about absolutely everything.
Where are you from, Simon? Ireland.
Okay.
Cool.
Ireland.
Being in six Americans, that's more of a culture shock to me than actually being in Paris.
I think that Simon and I instantly bonded because he could sense that he could be comfortable with me.
She's got like a really warm quality.
Someone here?
And then.
Yeah! Whoa!
What's up, big champions?
Do you have any idea how long we've been walking?
I'm Adam.
Nice to meet you, CT.
Hi, Adam.
Simon, nice to meet you.
Adam.
Ace is definitely hot and better looking than I am. And CT is probably too. I mean, he's taller and he's bigger and he's stronger.
Simon. Nice to meet you.
As Christina walks through the door, I just think she's on fire, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She's got a body. Oh my god.
This place is fantastic.
Oh! I'm on my way. Yeah.
Confession!
Alright. So Christina, I really can't stand her. Again, I know Christina and Leah, and then Simon, CT, Ace.
Mallory.
Yes. Like family ties.
Yeah, like family ties.
The only other Mallory I've ever met in my life.
Mallory is hot.
Wonderful. Definitely want to see the opera.
No kidding.
Yeah. I want to see everything.
You are cultured.
Oh, at the end of this experience, I want to know everything I can.
I'm looking at Mallory, and I'm thinking, I want my wife to look like that. I haven't known her that long. All these thoughts start flying through my head about how beautiful she is and how I want to get to know her, and it's kind of driving me nuts.
I think three girls in one room, that's going to be a lot of estrogen.
It's a lot of female.
Yeah.
So you three stayed in here?
We think so. It's totally up to everyone.
We haven't had any direction.
We and Simon have the idea that we should room together. They just are so funny.
What's Simon in my life?
Oh, but you know what that means, though? That means that one of us is gonna have to be with a girl.
I've already dropped my bags on a bed. CT has his bags on the bed next to mine. Somebody's gonna get screwed, and it's gonna be Ace.
Have you ever lived with a girl before?
Yeah, one time.
Okay.
Nice girlfriend. Didn't go very good. At least we got our own bathroom here.
Yeah, we do have our own bathroom.
I think it's gonna be really good sharing a room with Christina. She wears her heart on her shoulder. And a lot on myself.
What is that? Looks like a coffin.
Yeah, my bare essentials.
Oh, what is that? What did you bring with you in the coffin?
Basically all the essentials.
What are props?
He only brought the necessary items.
I brought a bunch of just weird stuff. I'm gonna lighten the mood. If something's going wrong, I'm gonna make it better. Just making everyone have a good time.
You get pissed at somebody?
I brought boxing gloves so that, you know, if people were that frustrated with each other, that they can just throw on some gloves and they'll both look okay.
I'm not even thinking of picking those up. I can't take you, I can't take Ace. I probably could take Simon.
Do you look at the camera?
Where is it?
There.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
This is Simon.
This is Leah.
Reporting live.
From
Cali.
That was great on you. Yeah. We're in the mirrors.
Oh my god.
Does he switch it or is he?
Huh? Yeah, I'm straight as an arrow, baby. y'all are straight, right?
Well, you look,
Whatever floats your boat.
Yeah, whatever floats your boat.
Yeah.
Now, power
of. Where are we looking?
Yeah, right there. Power of three.
Yes!
We got really, really lucky.
You are!
Paris, here we come.
Get ready.
Handsome Simon! Thank you!
I'm getting ready to go out.
Tonight, we're all going for our first night out in Paris.
Every guy's gonna be hitting on you. I'm gonna have to beat him off.
I don't speak French.
Exactly. Just know what I'm saying. I can't sound stupid.
Guys don't like when girls talk anyways.
Oh, you messed with Supercut. Supercut here, okay?
Ace, he's very fun and he's very silly, and the number one characteristic in a man is somebody that can make you laugh on a daily basis. I'm a little attracted to Ace, yeah, I'll admit it.
Don't look too busy, but you do
want to
look available.
I think Ace's attraction to all of us. I am attracted to Ace because he has such a good personality.
I know for a fact that we're all attracted to Ace, and that's... He's got three girls to pick from.
Everybody felt awkward in the house asking Simon whether he was
homosexual or bisexual.
I don't feel the need to say to everybody I'm gay because I don't expect them to come up to me and say, you know, I'm straight.
I will tell you now, the boys do not mind.
Really?
Yes.
How do you know?
Because I've already talked to him about it. My gay art is perfect.
Mainly I'm relieved, but I do feel slightly paranoid because I don't really know what was said.
I'm actually doing something for the first time that's so outside of myself. Oh my gosh! I'm just thrilled.
I'm gonna stick with you.
Yeah, you stick with me and Leah, we'll sort you out.
It's awesome how we're all together and it's our first night out in a club.
Oh, this is fun. This is so much fun.
We're all dressed up. We all just want to have a bit of fun.
Let's do it.
I'll make sure you're on the Metro by 2.
We're going to make sure I'm not on the Metro by 2. Make sure I'm at home by 6, brother. All right? Just do that.
Will do.
I think by 4 we ought to be.
I just want to go in anywhere.
I love Paris at night.
Rebound!
I feel almost at home in my element. I could care less about the language. I could care less about what people think. It's just me and my friends. We're going out and we're hanging out.
Yeah, let's go, ladies.
Look at Tina!
The girls are all ready to bug out. They're in there. They're already, you know, starting to shake a little bit.
Leah has been sweating Ace. She doesn't care that Ace knows it. She wants him, man. She wants him bad.
Ace, look at me.
I'll show you spots.
I want to wake up sleeping.
Oh, you've had an ass bite. That's probably good.
You've never had an ass like mine.
No, ass biting.
Like you just said.
Bites your butt. So but I got a kissy girl.
You can't smoke it, can you?
My biggest turnoff to me is the girl that smokes. I just hate the way their breath smells, their hair smells, their clothes smell. It just disgusts me.
New York women, I don't know if they're really aggressive or what.
Apparently they are. I don't know if she's drunk or she's really serious or she just doesn't come that well.
She's both. She's drunk and she's serious.
You're not me, bro.
I know, you're not feeling it.
There's this girl I'm in love with back home. Cleveland, I think that's the one I'm gonna marry. Swear to God, man.
Kate is the girl that I was dating right before I left. And we really never discussed how we wanted things to be, but feeling like this might be the one. And I'm scared to do anything here that I might ruin back home.
I've never been in love, really.
I envy Ace to the fullest. I'm looking for what Ace apparently has right now. He's talking to me about some girl he loves, he cares about in Georgia that Ace is willing to forego opportunities here in Paris for. That's what I want.
You know I'm digging Mal. Like, I think Mal's the hottest one, but...
You know why you're digging Mal?
Because she's got an
unattainable one.
For sure.
My initial reaction is, this girl's great, I want to get to know her. And it's kind of sticking in my head.
Like, she's a virgin, she's young, she's really pretty, and she's just not digging anybody.
Yeah.
That's why you like her. You like what you can have.
It's probably true. It's
probably true.
You got a phone call.
Can you just tell her that I'll call her back?
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm sorry, she's really wiped out.
Oh, no problem, Adam. I figured she had too good of a time last night. And I know she likes to party hardy. We joke about the fact that her senior year was runner-up for party animal. I said if she didn't have her athletics, she would have been number one.
No kidding.
Yes.
I did not know that.
You look at a person like Mallory, and you say, wow, this is side of her that I want to get to know, and it's very exciting and intriguing. All I can think about is talking to her more, getting to know her more. But I don't want to seem too overzealous. I don't want to be chasing her around the house, trying to talk to her. Every day sounds overcast, so here I go, Dr. Groove. My writing is therapy. You know, my songs are therapy. It helps me get out a little bit of frustration, and it feels good. I will not be afraid to lie. I will not be afraid to cry. I will not be afraid inside, and I will not hide my family pride.
My father's a member of the Commodores, a band from the 70s and 80s.
No matter what I do, I don't think I'll ever be as successful or as good as my dad. I will not be afraid of this place or afraid of a girl who requires a chase.
I just suck at this game.
I wrote a song.
Did you?
And I'm gonna write a song a week.
The only time I ever write poetry is if it's about something that I have a lot of emotion and like a lot of feeling about.
Right, and doesn't it feel therapeutic?
It does, it does.
Oof. And like, it's maybe the songs suck, but at least I feel better after writing.
Yeah, can I hear it when you're done with
it?
Do
you really want to? I feel like Mallory and I have this connection. This makes me feel wonderful. I mean, she's actually interested in the song.
The song that Adam's writing, it's a way for him to kind of get out his feelings. It's kind of a good way to clear your mind.
Ooh. There's one part I can't sing to you. I have to skip it.
Oh, I wonder what that's about then.
Well, obviously it's about you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sick of hooking up and not remembering names, but I'm also sick of hiding feelings playing the game. But I will not be afraid to quit if a girl's not feeling me and giving me.
Starting to get a little more homey here now.
Good.
This room's so dirty, man, all the time.
Who's on that, Maxim?
My mom. That's her other, actually.
She's so pretty.
She's gorgeous.
My mother passed away of breast cancer 3 years ago.
My mom was always kind of like my sister. She was my person I got advice from, you know?
You don't have, like, girlfriends that you're close with?
Not like my mom, though, you know?
Yeah, well, no one's ever gonna be like your mother.
I'm scared of, you know, getting married one day and my wife getting it just scares me to death.
Absolutely.
And it was just so painful seeing my mom get through that. For 13 years, she fought it.
If that happened to me, when he asked me how my ribbon, I was like, it's for breast cancer. Like, I always have one on, no matter what. Pink ribbon is a symbol for breast cancer. It is me saying, this is my cause. When he talks about her, it's like, oh, God. It's like heartbreaking. And I thought that maybe that's why he thinks that smoking is such a big deal. Because it causes cancer. Which kind of makes me look at it like, I feel like it's like every time I smoke, I'm like spitting in his face. I feel bad. I can still hear Ace say to me, I don't want a wife, and then her die in 14 years and then be alone. Him saying that just keeps ringing in my head. Let me tell you. You know what I'm gonna do?
Really?
I'm gonna quit smoking.
Good, I wish you would.
This is it. I'm not gonna smoke anymore.
I'm really happy for Leah that she's trying to quit smoking. If there's any way I can help her out with this situation, I will help her.
It's not easy for me to quit smoking, but I live with someone who is reason enough to quit smoking.
You see you.
You know, I go into a situation, I liven it up everywhere we are. And, you know, I make things fun. It's for I get infatuated with people relatively quickly. Mallory has everything that I could ask for in a woman.
I like to party and I'm very outgoing. Every time I get drunk, I'm usually gonna make out with someone.
Are you great again?
I am great.
You're great?
I look at a woman's eyes, I can tell when she's attracted to me. You know, she gets excited. Mallory doesn't get excited. Call it chemistry, call it spark, whatever you want to call it, we don't have it. I want to have somebody. So if I can't have that somebody, I get a little bit frustrated, a little bit upset. And from that frustration, comes my temper.
As long as you agree with me, cool.
Agree with you?
Yeah.
Don't jump on me, please.
If anyone jumps on you, what?
I get mad.
Well, then get mad. Get mad at me, Mal.
Calm down.
I want to see you again. I want to see you show some sort of emotion.
I think Adam resents Mallory now because at first he was like, yeah, like Mallory, she's the one. And now he doesn't think he has a chance.
I'm not.
She's talking about like a zombie.
Leave her alone, Adam.
Stop. I'm a bit shocked. I never saw this before.
He's on the road for that person.
I'm like, Adam, relax, will you? What's your problem? Just take it easy.
Yeah, it is.
Oh my gosh, I've seen tons of emotion from you, so he can't really claim that argument. If he wants to get a rise out of me, he's got a long way to go.
I'm the least sensitive of everybody, and if something that I take sensitive, it's gonna be very sensitive.
Especially to Mallory.
To Leah or to Mallory.
I apologize, Mal.
It's fine. It's totally fine. That's okay. I'm just not. I don't like. Sometimes you're a little.
You don't like me. That's bottom line.
No, that's okay.
I'm just kind of angry because I know that I'm not important to anybody in this house. I make my friends' lives better at home, just being me, and I don't have that here.
If people hate each other in the house, it kind of just divides us, and that's one thing I don't want.
This is how we do it.
Where I come from, okay?
What are you doing?
We are about to get the jacuzzi at 104 degrees.
What are you doing?
Fahrenheit, baby!
Ace is just about having a good time. That's it, bottom line. Don't matter where you're from, you know, it's where you're at.
I'm not doing this for me, I'm doing this for us. For us.
I hate when people fight, it just kills me. I want everybody to have a good time and for everybody to laugh and to hang out. That's the most important thing to me.
Let it go, baby.
Y'all do this all the time, or from?
Me by how to.
Just trust me.
This is how we do it.
You're not getting in the hot tub?
4:15, I want to start getting up at like 2 p.m.
Hello there, Viking.
How's my job? Cool
is
there?
Is it working? Is it hot? And the idiot in the Viking hat made this work.
I know how to do this, baby.
What's your full name?
Clyde Allen Bird.
Clyde, that's a sexy name.
Hey, what else could you see me being called if I weren't nice?
I like Clyde Allen. I think that's pretty hot.
Leah's openly stated that she wants Ace.
She knows what she wants, and she knows how to get it. Well, she thinks she knows how to get it.
Have y'all seen a girl with the red lungs? Who wants to compete? Okay.
I don't want to cheat.
One, two, three.
But fight is that.
I had my ass bit.
Yeah, you did.
I think she just likes scaring me.
Give it up to the
South.
Best friends of the
God. We brief you about the roomies.
Yes.
There's Ace, who's really, 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 really cute from Georgia. I was like, Ace, like, let's just get the job done. He's like, I've never met a girl as straightforward as you. And I was like, all right. So I scared the shit out of him, and now I feel like he won't even talk to me.
Why don't you just hook up with what's her name?
Will ya?
Yeah.
Give him kind of like peace offering, like bake it. Kind of like.
No, but I can't keep my hands off him. I can't. So I'm gonna, I kind of want to grab him.
Just bite his butt.
I did.
Okay, you're gonna, right?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Okay, you're gonna.
Goddamn, you're on.
I'm gonna, right?
Yeah, I did. I'm gonna do it.
Right now, she understands that there's gonna be no like significant relationship. It's the same thing. It's hooking up with her.
Let's string it attached. I swear to God, the first day, if I was like, listen, I think you're so wonderful. I think me and you ought to date and be perfectly together. She'd be like, whatever, get away from me.
This is a bunch of skip.
Get
right into it.
Girls love what they can't
have. Yeah, no,
every sense of the way, every minute of the day.
You're absolutely right.
Liam will want to see that. Oh my God. There's a naked Viking running in the house. Wait, oh my God.
Liam, did you see that?
I just don't know why I'm ready to do this. Like, it's hard to do the long distance relationship thing. I think I'm in love with her, though, man.
You think that, you know, she could be the one that she could tolerate you, and then give it a shot, bro.
Yeah, and that's the main thing, tolerating me.
That's what I'm saying, just give it a shot. You don't know until you try, man.
I'm just kind of confused about the whole Kay situation. I can see myself being with her, but then, you know, 5 months is a long time.
I love you so much.
I know, I miss you so much. Do you want me to come see you?
Yes, I definitely want you. I miss you so much.
Ace knows I'm attracted to him, but I know that there are boundaries that should not be crossed.
I'm just gonna wait to see you. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Are you doing the same?
Yes.
Are you not dating anybody?
No.
If you don't talk to anybody, I won't talk to anybody.
Okay, well then we'll make that.
You want to make it official?
Yeah.
And nobody in our house, I promise you, not one person. I mean, there's no, like, attractions, really.
Nia is struggling with an insecurity because of the fact that Ace doesn't really seem to be interested in her in the same way that she's interested in him. Group unity, and I would feel a bit more comfortable if there wasn't issues bubbling between people.
I don't have a snowflake's chance in hell with Mallory.
Oh, no.
The only reason we're on this earth is to procreate, and all that love, it's a bonus.
Adam really seems notable.
I'm sick of that.
You can see the tension building up. It's like a tidal wave slowly forming.
And you girls can get it anytime you want it.
No, that's not
true.
He's got
some guy, though. And you're dumb.
Soon you just know it's gonna crash.
You may not be able to get it from Ace right now, but you can get it.
It was an open face slap. Bam, you cannot get a guy like that.
May not be able to get it from like the top 0.0001%, which is exactly what my boy Ace is. Yeah, old me, girl, you were the top.
So are you saying that I can't get a top 5 guy? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
You're wrong.
Absolutely.
You're wrong.
Ace might be able to win, like, Mr. Georgia.
Why don't you break down some layman's terms? What are you saying right now?
I'm saying that you're too picky. That's what I'm saying. You're too picky. If you want a guy like Ace, no. You can't have him.
Are you kidding me?
You can't have Ace. I'm calling it right now. You can't have Ace.
You think I can't get a guy like him? You're beat. You are so dead wrong. You are so wrong. Why don't you come to New York, hang with me, and see the that I pull?
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's a full-blown invitation right there. You come hang with me, and I'm telling you right now, you won't be able to pull a chick anywhere.
I won't be able to pull a chick.
Pick your jaw. No, not a hot chick.
No?
No.
Okay. Here's the fact. Ace, hot to the world. You throw yourself at him, and you don't have an iceberg's chance in hell with Ace. He wouldn't with my all right? That's the fact.
no flattery at all to me. This is just terrible to me, and I hate it.
I really don't want to talk right now.
No, talk to me. Please talk to me. You can talk to me. You know, he didn't mean it being mean at all.
Because the way she took it, I got out of control.
And he's just think before he speaks. I think he's a bit of a hothead.
Well, he's not very good with words. He didn't really know how to talk.
Yeah.
Adam runs off emotion. He doesn't think about what he's gonna say before he says it. It just comes right out.
My frustrations in the house have been building up, and this was kind of the top popping off the can, but unfortunately, I hit the wrong person. I mean, Leah didn't deserve that.
I really just want to go to sleep.
All right, let me check you in.
That's good.
She's almost turning the light off.
Yeah, sure, I'll tell.
You bringing up a point like that personal, that would tweak me the wrong way, you know? You kind of see how that would tweak someone, like especially a girl?
Yeah, absolutely.
My mother always tells me, think fast, talk slow. Well, I think fast, talk fast, and it's caused a problem my whole life, and this is just another example.
I think that you should just kind of give her a space and kind of, I think you'll be a better person for trying to.
Trying to what? Like, either way on the app.
This season on The Real World.
I just had the greatest idea. Limbo contest!
Yeah! She is a lot wilder than she claims to be. Who wouldn't like me, right? Mallory, to me, gets prettier every day.
I don't even know if you remember, but we kissed each other.
I feel like such a dork.
Dear roommates, we're hiring each of you to write new travel guide series.
I'm primarily looking for the places you're going to find.
We're going to Switzerland.
Yes!
One, two, one, two.
Venice.
Ooh, Rome.
What do you want from me?
I've been listening to this all night.
I think CT wants to present himself like I really don't care.
Where do you think my bed is?
But on the inside, I don't think he feels that way.
I want to get that drink.
Mallory, why don't you come outside now, Mallory?
No,
I don't think she needs to be an adult right now.
You touch me. What you want?
The Leak on MTV.com brings you Radiohead. Log on now to hear Radiohead's entire new album before it hits stores on June 10th.